What are you gonna do? 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 What are you gonna do?
You know, we've been asking ourselves all through this series, what are we gonna do? What are we gonna do? We've been at this for 55 years now, and a question that we could ask is what we've been doing the right thing? Does it actually work? We've been tackling probably the most complex, biggest problem on the planet, fighting poverty and helping children be released from poverty in Jesus' name. Poverty rolls down through the generations though. I mean, grandpa to daddy to son. And it says a message into the heart of a little child at each generational level that says basically, you know, give up. Nothing's ever going to change for you. I've asked myself for a long time, are we doing really the right thing? And I had that question answered for me a little while ago. I was in Uganda. We were actually launching the Alumni Association, a network of graduates of Compassion's program. And so we had a big parade of us. So we must have had several thousand of us marching through the streets of Kampala with big banners and everything. We marched down to the football stadium. And when we got to the football stadium, the bleachers all around it were filled, and out in the very center of the field was this big platform. And I was asked to give a little bit of a talk, a little overview of who is Compassion and why do we do what we do. So I was telling the various parts of Compassion, our leadership development program, and our sponsorship program, CDSP, that is the heart and soul of what we do in the midst of the lives of children. But then I got to the child survival program, and standing in the hot sun of Uganda, it occurred to me that maybe we need a visual aid of some sort here. So I asked, does anyone have a child, a little baby that I can hold while I talk about the child survival program? And from the bleachers under an awning, out came a mother and a young man with this little baby. And they handed this little tiny Ugandan boy to me. So I was talking about our child survival program and how very precious each and every child is, that God knows how many hairs are on their head and the pattern of their fingerprints, and has a wonderful plan for this little boy, and our job is to help him be strong while he's small and grow up to be a strong person who blesses Uganda. Well, the little baby fell asleep while I was talking out there. So I just held him, and mom and dad were standing at the bottom of the platform just waiting. So I just held him and I finished my talk. And when I got finished with the talk, I went to hand this little Ugandan baby back to his mother. And she smiled up at me and she said, "By the way, this baby's daddy and I are both sponsored children ourselves." And I said, "Really?" And they said, "Not in the same project, but we met and we've been married, and this is our first child." And I looked at this beautiful little baby, and being kind of in a silly mood, I said, "Does this child need a sponsor?" I'll never forget, because this young mother looked up at me and she smiled as tears welled up in her eyes, and she said, "No. He doesn't need a sponsor. We know how to take care of our child." And then this young man standing beside her said, "Yeah, poverty stopped with us." And I thought, oh my goodness, what are we gonna do? What are we doing? Is it the right thing? Does it work? Is it strategic? Does it build the kingdom of God? Does it help a generation of children be released from poverty in Jesus' name? Yeah, it really, really does.
You gotta do. What are you gonna do?